I think that I liked the arts already as a child. The matter is that I didn't know that this was going to be my life. I loved cartoons and my dream was to draw some characters. A competition was planned, but nobody registered, so the only choice was to take advertising design. In order to take advertising design, you had to know painting and drawing. Therefore, I had to study the basics of drawing. I discovered there was an art school and that there was a lot of people like me. I was not from Mars. We were a crowd. It had been a long process before I discovered I was an artist, but I didn't think that one day I was going to be immersed in this field as my life project. My life preferences had been around the animals. I loved them. In the event that I wasn't accepted at art school, I would be a vet. I applied to vet school twice, but didn't make it. I wanted to do something involving little animals, something that could help them, where I could talk people into showing respect to the animals' lives. A struggle, or something like that, to fight for their welfare. At school, I took some courses and compared animal anatomy. I discovered there was a way, but a difficult one. Since I had taken 4 years studying the human figure, but not 4 years on animal figure. Therefore, I had to discover it by myself. I was required to do human figure, which I did just because I had to, but I also did animal figure. I started to study the horse figure from the outside, not the subjective side of the horse, the anatomy, its beauty, what I could shape about the horse. As time passed, I discovered the emotional part, the spiritual side of the horse, what we all human beings have inside, that inner animal side full of energy, of strength, fueled with emotions. I got interested in getting more involved in the issue, and I didn't only draw or copy it, it was even more. It was that it was coming alive within myself, and I was trying to show all those emotions in my paintings, the movement, the human side of animals. When I want to portray a song in my painting, I give it a lot of rhythm and I paint the horses moving. They split in all directions, a free, open composition. This is the composition in this painting, open and in motion, uneasy. Energy is given by color. Yellow is a vigorous and warm color. There are faces perhaps more spiritual, more celestial, given by violet tones. The majority of the horses are white, giving a kind of more ancestral space, more of a superior plane, and are more metaphysical, more philosophical too. It makes people tend to think, to meditate more. Warm colors supply that uneasiness, that movement. I paint warmth a lot. I love to use reds, oranges, yellows, but I like to paint them uneasy, jumping. My technique is a mixed one. It is oil paint and different textures. I use acrylic as a medium. This is a dough for molding, and through it I use resources like cardboard, fabric, sand, pebbles, etc. This dough allows me to do that. Horses are a symbol of freedom. They symbolize strength, energy, all the ideals I have in my inner self. All that is freedom, the desire of going several places. I'm a different person when I paint. Being a mother and an artist is my greatest accomplishment. After giving birth to Sebastian, I think something changed. I feel more self-sufficient, willing to achieve greater projects, making him proud of his mother. This is a painting I did in 1990. In those times, they were living objects that lived in a higher plane on this painting. Now I think I have evolved from it, and I feel I can go even further. I can't say how I will be painting next year, because I don't know the path this will take me along. Since every stage is different, and I'm sure that I'll grow, and that I will have to get better. I will get better.